Hey Brandon, what's up? This is Past Brandon. I'm here to talk to you about your inconsistency on YouTube. And yes, this is going to be a public video. And no, you're not gonna delete it. You're gonna leave it on the channel. It'll be a reminder, like, well, kinda your very first video. Remember how the quality of your very first video was Five Nights at Freddy's 4, Night 1, you didn't even beat the night. And audio quality, it's about the same as it is now. It wasn't horrendous or anything, but the video quality, you butchered that in editing. It's god-awful, and you purposefully did not, redo the video or go back to the original video and try to salvage it. No, you kept it the piece of crap it is because you were like, you know what? I'm going to just remember this, and, you know, hey, first video, mistakes were made. I'm going to learn from it. And what was the other one? The 20 subscriber special with the horrendous echo. And that ended up not being the cord's fault. You threw away a cord. You didn't need to. The cord was perfectly fine. It was actually a problem with your software settings. I'm pretty sure it was OBS's settings at the time. You don't use anything else to mux or edit your audio. It's all just a one package in the MP4 that OBS records. So, yeah, the audio was horrible. You got it right. You didn't delete that or redo that video. You left it up there to remind yourself, hey, mistakes have been made in the past. I want to learn from this. You know, don't throw away hardware in the future. Just see if you can reprogram or redo. You can't program pretty much anything, but you know what you can do? You can mess around with settings, and you can delete folders around in the computer where histories and precedents have been saved up. You can delete those and then start over from scratch. It sucks, but it fixes problems. And those videos are there to remind you of those things. Well, this video is going to be a reminder to you to stop messing up the timing on your YouTube video. And if you do mess up, there will be this video kind of just lingering there. Even if it's not in any playlist, even if it should be in a playlist, but you haven't created that playlist yet, even though you've been on YouTube for almost a year, you still haven't created a bunch of playlists organizing all of your videos and categorizing them. And you could find a folder for this somewhere. You could find a place for it. But even if you don't do that, and I'll be honest, I don't believe you're going to do that at any point soon. Probably not within the next week, probably not even within the next month. It'd be nice if you did, it'd be great if you did. I don't think you're going to do that. But this video is going to be here, and you're going to know it's going to be there, and it's going to remind you, hey, I need to tighten a few things up. I need to get a few things right. And feel free to watch this in full. Not just have it in the back of your memory. Please feel free to watch this in full at some point, at any point in the future, as a reminder of back in the day when you had some stuff wrong and you reminded yourself that you need to get a few things correct. The scripture that I'm going to shoot your way is this one, and it is crucial to the overarching point that I'm going to be presenting to you. And it is Luke chapter 14. Let's start at verse 28. For which of you, intending to build a tower, does not sit down first and count the cost, whether he has enough to finish it? Lest after he has laid the foundation and is not able to finish, all who see it begin to mock him, saying, this man began to build and was not able to finish. If you're going to do something, you want to do it right. You want to do it proper. You want to do it in such a way as to where you went into it knowing what it was going to cost and then, you know, paying the price to get it done. Now, with YouTube, it's slightly different. I knew it would involve time. I knew it would involve some editing. I didn't know editing was going to be such a huge pain in the butt. I didn't know editing would be something I would grow to loathe and borderline hate. Is it full-out hatred? Well, I think it's full-out hatred. But it is at very least despised. It's close to hatred. Editing sucks, and that's one of the reasons you don't edit a lot of your videos. You could probably make time for it, but it's such a hassle. It's such a pain. And trust me, I understand. I really do understand. But there's and the time commitment you also you didn't see the time commitment coming. YouTube, even on a small scale like you have, it's ridiculously time consuming. Like, even preparing for this video. Yeah, there were definitely distractions. There were lots of distractions. Which is pretty normal for you. You're an ADHD guy. You grew up that way, and it's a lot better than it used to be. But it's still there, and it can still come and bite you in the rear end every now and then. But yeah, planning a video for hours, and then sometimes, especially with the editing thing, with the videos you do edit, yeah, hours. A significant amount of time. If you want to just play video games, it'd be a lot easier to just do them on your own, quite frankly, instead of doing this YouTube thing. Yeah, it's neat to have a little record, but you really could just do it on your own. Save yourself quite a bit of time. But you had a dream and you had a vision. You wanted to share your love of video games with the world, with the thousands, if not tens of thousands, who already do it on YouTube. But you were going to throw in a twist. You were going to make sure that you threw in some Jesus every now and then. And then, after talking to your pastor and getting some encouragement from him, you were like, you know what? I'm not just going to do video games some days a week and then preaching a few days a week. No, I'm going to do 2 videos a day. And that's what most YouTubers do. You're going to do a video game video, and you're also going to do a Jesus video. And you're going to do it, and you decided this from the very beginning, before that very first Five Nights at Freddy's video. You're going to do this twice a day. 2 videos a day. 1 video game, 1 Jesus. That's what you decided. You did your very best at the beginning to count the cost. You did that well. You did it to the very best of your ability, and you know you did. I know you did. But along the way, several prices came up, and they were just unexpected. We didn't see them coming. And just to kind of stick with this analogy, you go to build something, you go to try to do something. With any big project, there are going to be unforeseen circumstances. And unforeseen consequences, that's simply a matter of human nature. It's a matter of the way this world works. When humans go to build something, and you're a human, so you're not excluded from this, no matter how wonderful, brave, smart, intelligent, and handsome you are. No sarcasm there, I promise. There are going to be unforeseen circumstances and consequences. That's simply a matter of any human endeavor. And yeah, the editing was way more than you thought, and the time was also way more than you thought. And after several months, yeah, you definitely had your moments where you were like, do I want to keep doing this? Channel's growing. It's not growing incredibly fast. Do I want to keep this up? Should I call it quits at some point? And you decided, no, I really want this. It's a little dream that I had. The Lord hasn't told you to do it. God hasn't told you you shall build a YouTube channel. You prayed about it, and God said it was okay. You know, it was fine that you did the YouTube channel, but He didn't give you a command to do it. He didn't give you direct commission to do this. This is not a calling, and if He wants you to drop it, you need to drop it. Just saying. But He said, yeah, go for it. And so you're like, you know what? To the best of my ability, I've counted the cost, and I'm going to go for it. Well, you've done it for a little while, almost a year. Dude, almost a year. That is so crazy to think about. Coming up this April. Yeah, I started on April Fool's Day, April the 1st. That was great. That was a good idea. That was a good idea you had right there. I like that. I like that quite a bit. Coming up in April, 1 year on YouTube. And you haven't done 2 videos a day. Now, granted, we're all human. We're all going to make mistakes, right? I get that. I totally get that. And I tend to be the type where when I'm doing something, I tend to make mistakes along the way. Not a ton. And once, well, actually, hold on. What I do is I make every mistake in the book possible. Like not even having a proper video editor to begin a YouTube channel with. That's pretty phenomenal right there. Actually, YouTube was planned out better than most anything else you've done. Like you put a few months time and effort into thinking about it. In fact, when you were putting all the equipment together, when you were like, okay, what do I need to get? You really did your research. You really did a good job. You were like, Okay, what do I really need to make this thing work? What equipment do I need? What equipment is good? You know, what programs do I need? Like you didn't used to ask. Something's in the eye here. So annoying. But yeah, you actually, that thing's not leaving the eye. Keep talking. I'm just gonna keep talking. You keep listening, Brandon. But yeah, you really did your best to count the cost. You did your best to look into the equipment. You probably put more effort into this than, well, gosh, quite frankly, anything else you did in your life. Like, school wasn't too hard. School was pretty easy. Homework was pretty easy when you deigned to do it at all. And never really need to study, didn't need to put a whole lot of effort into it. Academics and data, you're really good with. Like no boasting, no pride or anything. Like you're good at it. You genuinely are. You know what you're doing there. It comes easy to you. YouTube, it was a brand new thing. And even though you wanted to jump into it just like Mark Senpai told you to do. That's Markiplier for all the non-weebs that may or may not listen to this. He was just like, just if you want to do YouTube, just hop in and do it. Just start. And you want to do that. And you eventually decided on April the 1st to do that. Like, I don't know everything. I've done months of research, tons of thinking, tons of preparing. You made so many videos in advance. Oh, dude, I remember how many videos you made in advance. You really, my gosh, you really did prepare for this more than anything else you did. You've done your entire life, haven't you? Like even college, you didn't put this much thought into. But here you are, not doing half bad. And God's also a very good God. He's blessed you tremendously. But yeah, you put so much effort and thought into this, but you did eventually come to the point where, like, okay, I've done so much prep and I've done so much planning. I'm just gonna hop into this. I'm just gonna do this. I'm just gonna do this. And I'm, wow, and that camera does not like what I did there. Holy smoke. This camera doesn't like to refocus very well either. You didn't know that about the camera, but you went with the advice of your friend and you got something a little bit on the cheaper side. It's still HD. Still 1080p, 60 fps, or claims to be anyway. And it doesn't do a half bad job. It really doesn't. So it's not a horrible thing. But yeah, you really tried for this thing, and you did your best, and eventually, after a ton of prep, you hopped into it, even though everything wasn't quite where you needed it to be, and it wasn't quite ready, and it wasn't quite finished. And I would still say to anyone else getting into YouTube, get a few more things down than I did. Do a little bit more prep work. Who knows? Maybe I'll make a video on that at some point once I feel like I've got a proper foundation and a proper beginning. Almost a year into this, and I almost think I know how to begin. I wonder if all human endeavors are like that. I wonder if building all towers are like that. All human endeavors involve consequence and coincidence and circumstance. There's nothing you can do about it. I wonder if all of them end up this wild and wacky, and just so many things coming your way that you just had no idea were coming. You do your best to prepare, but there comes a point where you just have to hop in and do it. And even if you're absolutely confident and you've prepared even better than I did, and I did like, I would almost say more than enough prep. Like I prepared again for months in advance. So, and you know that feeling. You were there. So much prep work was done, and there was so much I didn't know. So much you had to learn. And so, no regrets hopping into it. No, not at all. This has been a very good thing. But there was so much you still needed to learn. I just wonder how many towers are built? How many towers are erected? And the person really tried. Like, so many people don't try, and then indeed, people just look and are like, dude, you didn't do a good job there. You really didn't know what you were doing. You really got in over your head, didn't you? With this YouTube thing, I mean, I am still here, almost a year going into it. I haven't given up, haven't caved in, haven't given into the pressure. And there has been pressure, as small as my channel is, and as it pains me to say it, as low as the quality is, I've done my best, and I've really tried. and I make every kind of mistake that's possible to make going into something. And then after a while, I get pretty good at it, and it becomes rote and routine, but I become good at it. It becomes decent. And I haven't reached that point yet on YouTube, and I'm going to keep on trying. I'm going to keep putting in that effort. I'm going to keep persevering because I want to do good. But it has certainly not been without consequences. Now, I'm not opposed to taking a break. Now, I'm not opposed to any YouTuber. Well, one, they can do with their channel as I please. You can do with your channel as you please. But I really, really do believe in just letting your subscribers know, hey, I'm going to be gone from this point to this point. If an emergency comes up, yeah, you do what you need to do. Oh my gosh, do what you need to do. But other than that, short of that, if it's just a vacation, and I do think some YouTubers could use some vacations, not mentioning anyone. It's like, oh my gosh, every big YouTuber does not take a single day off. And I really think they need to. A Sabbath break is a very, very good thing. But yeah, taking a break is fine and good, and I want to encourage you to do so. But there have been many times, and today is one of those times, where things didn't get put out on time, and you missed an entire day, and you had to come back and apologize for it. Now, knowing you, just being bluntly honest, you're going to make some mistakes. The pressure's going to get to you, and you're going to crumble. Maybe not completely. You know, the YouTube channel's still here. Not horribly. You're not going to go through some kind of midlife crisis, and you're 36. You're pretty much in midlife. Just suck it up and get over it. You're not young anymore. That's simply the truth of the matter. But you're going to crumble under pressure. You're going to make mistakes. You're going to make every mistake in the book. And it was bound and determined to happen that you're going to make some mistakes, and you are going to... One of those mistakes was going to be, you're going to miss some days. You're not going to stick to your schedule, but holy smoke. You did not foresee how little personal discipline you had. YouTube was the first thing you really picked up in your entire life that you wanted to pick up. I mean, ministry is good and Jesus is good. Don't get me wrong. You chose Jesus. After he chose you, you chose him back and you said yes to him. He called you to ministry. You said yes to him. And that's awesome. And this is a part of that ministry. And that's good and that's great. But with Jesus, there are commandments. There are things you need to do. With your job, there are timelines and duties that are expected of you. Back when there was school, you knew what your classes were. You knew when they were scheduled. And you were told what the homework was going to be that was due next week. In all these things, your environment was structured. You had people telling you what to do. Even God, your Father, he told you what to do. He tells you what to do, and he will tell you what to do. He won't leave you guideless. But YouTube was the first thing that you wanted to do yourself, that you wanted to put effort into, that you really cared about. And that's awesome. And I wonder if that's why God said yes. Because it was the first thing you really wanted to do. It was the first time you said, this is a task at hand that I want to do that isn't just a game. It involves games. So it's not quite totally like something independent from you. And of course, if you're going to choose something, it's going to be something you like to do. I mean, that's who you are. If you're going to do it and you're going to choose to do it, it's going to be something you like. That's who you are as a person. I completely understand that. I even encourage that. By all means, do that. If you're going to choose to do something you like. And if anyone else happens to watch this video, you guys do what you like as well. If you find something that you like, go for it with all your heart and don't hold back. But my gosh, I knew you didn't have a ton of self-discipline. I knew that was something you were lacking. But holy smoke, until you jumped into your own project, I had no idea how bad it was going to be. You've missed day after day after day after day. Well, you've got something written down here, and I'm going to read it. The public's going to know. The public is going to know. Where have you got it written down? Somewhere around your computer? Am I holding the piece of paper right here? I am. 13 messages, One of them, 30 minutes. You missed a 30-minute message. And 14 video game videos that those are days that you've missed and not made up. But that's not including the days that you missed and you made up. You put out like four or even six videos that day. Two video game videos, two preaching videos, or three video game videos, three preaching videos. This isn't including those days that you made up. These are days you have not yet made up. That have just disappeared and gone. And you thought you were going to, on that vacation, that Christmas vacation, you thought you were going to work and actually make up some of those videos and release a slew of videos after that. But that didn't happen. That didn't happen. You took the week off, you enjoyed it. And there's nothing wrong with that. That's okay. You took a Sabbath rest, a whole week, a vacation, and there is nothing wrong with that. Every now and then, maybe even more than once a year, that's okay. And it is your channel. You can do as you please. Just let the audience know in advance. The problem is all of these days you've missed were not intended. They weren't emergencies. You apologized for most of them. I don't think you apologized for all of them. You apologized for most of them. And then there were some days where you just disappeared. And you don't have a huge following. You don't have a huge subscriber base. And the amount of video, the amount of views that you have per video, pretty on the small side at the moment. And sometimes you think, well, it doesn't really matter if I miss a day. Come on. Sometimes that thought crosses your mind. You don't want it to. You desperately don't want to even think about that thought crossing your mind. You don't even want to think about the thought. But it does. It's only human to have a few doubts. I mean, my gosh. Even Jesus had to pray for strength in the Garden of Gethsemane. Come on. If God can have a moment of weakness, you're allowed. That's not a sin. That's not wrong. But the important thing is you keep going and you keep doing it. And that's something you failed to do up to this point. Even today, 30-minute message is coming out Tuesday morning? Bro, come on. Come on. You can do better than this. And even if YouTube isn't something you do like until you're old, like older than you are now, nyuk, nyuk, nyuk. This self-discipline thing is something you need to get under control. And I want to encourage you, Brandon, do not give up this channel. Don't stop what you're doing until your own personal life, as well as YouTube, is much more disciplined than this. When your days are disciplined, scheduled, focused, when you make a plan and you stick with it and you're doing this consistently over several months of time, at that point, if you feel like you want to move on to something other than YouTube, then go for it. But I want to really encourage you, don't stop until you reach that discipline point. Right now, especially since your subscriber base is small, YouTube is primarily for you. And let's be honest, it's always going to be for you. You're going to put things out that you're interested in. You're going to put out things that you want. Heck, you're even thinking about just focusing on one video game at a time, like you did with Dark Souls. That ended up being more your style. You tend to not only be ADHD, you also tend to be OCD. In addition to being attention deficit hyperactive disorder, you also tend to be obsessive compulsive disorder. So when you finally do settle on something, when you finally find something that gets your attention and can hold your focus, it holds it for a long time, sometimes longer than it should. And that's how you enjoy video games. And that's fine. Well, maybe it's not fine. But for now, we're going to say it's fine. We're going to assume it's fine. And you want to do the channel, you just want to upload a ton of Mortal Kombat PvPs when you get around to it, fine. You want to upload a bunch of Dark Souls videos when you and your friend Robert get around to it, fine. But do it daily. Do it consistently. Dude, you haven't even gotten around, as of this date, this is a Tuesday, January the 10th of 2017, you've owned your video game, you've owned your video editing software for over a month, and you still don't know how to function with it. Because you haven't found the time. The time has been there. You could have learned how to do it. Even while putting up two videos a day, you could have done it. So anyone else watching this video, don't feel sorry for him. Don't make excuses for him. He could have done it, but he didn't, because he didn't discipline his time. He was busy playing a video game off camera, He was busy hanging out with a friend. Nothing. He was busy watching YouTube videos. None of those things are sinful or wrong. But your time wasn't structured. You didn't do it right, Brandon. And this video is a reminder to you that you need to get that right. Okay? And don't stop YouTube until you do, bud. I love you. I believe in you. I have faith in you. And more importantly than that, Jesus loves you and believes in you. And he has a plan. He's allowing this YouTube thing to happen. So even if he's not directly calling you into it, if he's allowing it, you know that you live for him and you love him. So you know his hand's going to be on it. He's going to bless it. And he's going to teach you a lot of stuff with it. And he's going to do some really cool stuff with it while he's at it. So keep it up, man. Keep it up. Definitely until you get this discipline thing underway. And right now, I know you're thinking what I'm thinking. Let's keep it going for several years to come. Even if at some point it's not two videos a day, even if it's not that rigid a schedule, keep doing YouTube because it genuinely is fun. It really, even though it's a pain in the butt with the editing sometimes, and some days I really would like to take off. But I really like it. A job that I actually don't despise. Something that, a mantle that I will willingly wear, a job that I will willingly work. That's an amazing thing. We'll see what the future holds. I don't know what kind of time you have coming your way. And you know some of the plans that you have for the future. And they're pretty big. And they're going to be pretty time consuming. So we'll see how things go. But keep that YouTube video up. Watch this at least one more time. Like, you're not going to edit it. You want this to be raw and uncensored, and you like your talking videos that way. Actually, you like your video game videos that way. Not only, yeah, you're a bit lazy, let's be honest, you're a bit lazy. You like your unedited videos because, oh my gosh, it saves time having to go through that thing and take out the parts that are a little bit boring, only include the parts that are juicy, and, you know, make it a little bit more interesting, spicing it up. That it takes time. And then there's the rendering and the processing where your computer can't do anything else but render and process. So for the longer videos, you have to actually do that overnight because you essentially lose the ability to do anything on your computer other than watch some YouTube videos and surf the internet. You can't even play games on your computer. But that being said, you do like the unedited videos. It's not just all laziness. You like how raw it is. You like how uncensored it is. You like how mistakes are left. You feel that's a bit more open and honest. It's not just laziness. You really do like that. This video is not going to be edited. It's going to be left as raw with all the uhs and all the ums and no jump cuts. Not, I don't really like a ton of jump cuts in talking anyway, so I'm not sure if I'll ever include that. But watch this video just one more time. Put it on YouTube and give yourself a view. Go for it, man. I think it'll be good. I think it'll be good if you do that. If you did do that, thank you, me, for watching that video. And anyone else watching this video, thank you for watching this video as well. This was, as you can tell by the length, a 30-minute message. It included the Bible verse. And today, guys, I needed to preach it myself. I'm done addressing me. I'm now going to address you guys. For anyone who's watched this video to this point, this weird little experiment in talking to myself, tell me what you thought down in the comments below. I thought it was kind of enjoyable. It was kind of different and unique, and I liked it. I liked it a lot. But I needed to be honest with myself, and I wanted to put out something publicly so there would be no excuses. And again, I want to be completely gut-level honest with myself and with you guys. I want everyone to know who I am, what I'm all about, and I want to keep it as real and as raw as possible because I think that's where real life change occurs and that's where real emotions are felt. Like, you want something good, it's going to be when it's in its rawest, most uncensored form. And that's where you get to learn who people really are, when they're not edited, where they're not cut. And even here, there's still going to be so much on the screen that I can't show, some things you guys simply won't learn about me just because your camera's not following me 24/7. And trust me, watching me sleep for, you know, 8-9 hours, that'd be very Very boring. I don't think anyone would want to watch that. I wouldn't want to watch that, for goodness sakes. But yeah.
Oh, excuse me.
Yeah. Woo. A little bit late for me, and I'm a little bit sleepy, but this is an important message. And for anyone who did watch it all the way, thank you so much for watching it. Thank you for supporting this channel, supporting what I do. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Hopefully it was something pleasurable to you. And since this is a 30-minute message, just for anyone who hasn't accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior, you can do it right now. You don't have to wait another minute. You can accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior right now. Just tell him that you believe he died on the cross for you and rose from the dead. And if you want a model prayer to follow, pray this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I admit that I'm a sinner. I believe you died on the cross, shedding your blood for me. And I believe you rose again 3 days later. Right now, I want to make you my God, my Lord, and my Savior. Please forgive all my sins. Wash me clean in the blood you shed on the cross. And thank you, Lord, very much for hearing this prayer and doing so. In Jesus' name, amen. And not another word or needs to be said, not another thought needs to be thunk, not another action needs to be performed. If you prayed that prayer and you meant it, you are a believer in Christ, you are a Christian, and you are on your way to heaven. That's awesome. Congratulations and welcome to the family. While I'm at it, find a Bible, read just a little bit every day. It'll get you to know your new God a little bit more than you knew him before. Shoot up a quick prayer to him a day just to thank you, God, for the day, or God, this day sucks, please help me. Something as simple and as quick as that, that is a genuine prayer if you mean it from your heart. And find a church home, find some people who agree with you that Jesus is God, that the Bible is the Word of God, that we need him. It'll be a great place to find new friends and a great place to find other people who will encourage you in this new walk that you have started upon. And for anyone who's watched the video to this point, once again, for I think this is the third time I've said it, and this will be the final time. Thank you so much for watching this video. Brandon, I love you very much. And to all my freaks out there, I love you guys very much. And just a random stranger, if you happen to watch all this video, I love you very much for what it counts and for what it's worth. A random internet dude, a small one at that, to say that, I do mean it, and I hope you believe it. Thank you so much. I love you, and God bless.